actually started roy raging a little bit. So
what do you think was behind the physical, just you pushing him? And
I don't know, maybe my presence, you know. I don't feel like he's acted like this with other fighters, so I feel like he knows he's got a real one in front of him. And maybe that strikes his ego the wrong way or something, but you know, I don't give a fuck how he feels about it. Come November 6th, I'm gonna whoop his ass.
Okay, great, go ahead. Pam?
You said a lot of things, but he said you offended his mom? Where did that come from?
I don't know, you tell me. How did I offend his mom? What about his mom, Justin?
That's what he said.
Hey, Caleb.
Huh? We're gonna move down. Go ahead.
Hey, Caleb, you talked about being from Nashville, not having anybody to look up to when you want to be a professional sports star. Now that you are that person for somebody, how does that make you feel?
I mean, it feels good. You know, I put a lot of work in to be here and get to this moment. And I hope that I can be an inspiration for somebody else, the younger kids coming up, on what it means to be a champion and to stay disciplined. And, you know, if you got a dream, then no matter where you're from or who you are, make sure you hang on to it. Because, you know, if you don't hang on to it, you know, who else is going to hang on to your dream?
So this you've always been a real cool, calm, collected guy. For him to kind of pull you out of that element, man, did this change your mentality going into the fight?
No, same mentality. Mentality doesn't change. I don't need to be any more motivated to win the Undisputed Super Middleweight Championship in the world. So,
congratulations, Chief.
IBF Super Middleweight Champion Taylor Plant. Champ, we've seen some crazy press conferences, but nothing like this. Did you expect it to get this
easy? You know, I was pretty open-minded. I wasn't sure how it was going to go, but, you know, I was prepared and ready. But, you know, he pushed me, and I went to hit him, and then he went to hit me. His arm hit my glasses and gave me a little scratch. That's why his arm was bleeding right there. It hit my glasses. But it's not too bad. It's not nothing I need surgery for or anything like that. It's just a small cut. But, you know, I just didn't want it to be, like, on my face or anything, so I put a little bit on me.
No one's ever...
He got one on me, I got one on him, so...
No one's ever stood up to Canelo like that. We're talking about the testing positive and no filter. What does that say about Canelo Plant?
I mean, I think that there should be more of that in this sport. You know, I don't think there's any room in this sport for cheaters. And, you know, a lot of people are quiet on those subjects and don't want to speak up on it, whether they're scared or whether they're cheating themselves. But, you know, if I feel it in my heart, then I'm going to say it. And he's a cheater. It's not up for discussion. He went to trial. He was convicted. He got 6 months suspension. You don't get that for not testing positive. He's a cheater. It's not up to me. I didn't. You need to take that up with the VADA or WADA or USADA or whoever. That's not up to me. That's up to them.
And lastly, his prediction is saying
it sounds good. He's supposed to say that, right? That's what all fighters say. I'm gonna knock him out. So he's supposed to say that. So, you know, he can say what he wants. But November 6th, when the bell rings, these fists are gonna do the talking. So.
Hey, Caleb.
Canelo mentioned that you crossed the line with his mother. And
what did I say about his mother?
No, Canelo says. Could you tell something about it, please?
I'm asking you, what did I say about his mother?
I was not there, but I'm asking because Canelo mentioned during the press conference that you crossed the line with his mother. You can tell no or...
No.
Nothing about it.
Do you know about my mom?
No, of course, no.
I'm asking, do you know about my mom?
Nothing.
Do any of y'all know about my mom?
No.
Where's she at? Okay, so you think I'm gonna be up there disrespecting people's mama?
That's great. That's a great answer. That's okay. And the second one, you say he's a cheater.
Huh?
You stand. You mentioned he's a cheater in front of him.
Is he?
Well, that's the question for you, not for me.
It's not a question. That's the answer. It's not a question. Was he suspended for 6 months?
Okay, finally, it's personal for you?
All fights are personal for me, man.
All fights?
All fights.
Go
good
down.
To see you.
Marcus Hayes, Fight Hub TV here with Mr. Caleb Plant. Caleb, you had a little testy moment up there with Canelo. Looks like you guys actually exchanged punches. Just take me back to that moment. What happened? It looked like a normal face-off.
Yeah, normal face-off, and then he pushed me, so I got one on him. He got one on me. My glasses hit my face, gave me a little scratch, so it is what it is.
How disrespected did you feel? Basically with him coming up to you and pushing you after he pushed you. Is that why you counter with the punch?
Yeah, that's why I counter.
No doubt.
Yeah, yeah.
You mentioned earlier about you being the only pro from Ashland. I talked the other day to Ty Tomlin, who looks up to you greatly.
Oh, yeah.
What would you tell him about today's, what happened about standing up for yourself? What would you say about it?
I mean, if you feel something in your heart, then just stick to it. You know what I'm saying? I didn't say anything. I didn't go out of my way to say anything, make accusations. Anything I said today was not an accusation. So if facts are facts, then you got to let the facts be the facts.
And talk about standing on those facts. A lot of the things, that pretty much everything that you said today could be proven as fact. Why do you think that Canelo and his camp take such umbrage to that type of conversation?
I'm not sure. I mean, if it wasn't true, then there'd be no reason to get mad about it, I guess. But, you know, seem like that's a soft subject, you know, a sensitive subject for him. So I'm not sure why. You'd have to ask him.
Lastly, Caleb, I'm going to end it with this. You've had a career where a lot of folks have been doubting you. There's been nothing but doubt. How motivated are you to take the titles away from Canelo and to be the true king at 68?
I'm motivated. I'm